So current affair will have two elements. So first polity section, then economy section, and then international relations, social issues, these things. So याद है सब कुछ क्या क्या पूछा गया था, मतलब अक्टूबर में आया था. अक्टूबर करंट अफेयर बुकलेट्स वी आर ऑलरेडी हैविंग, मतलब एट होम पढ़ा है उसका. ठीक है नहीं तो लगा. ठीक है तो फर्स्ट एक्चुअली न्यूज में है आपका पॉलिटिक्स है. Thing is that how actually we can utilize more important current affair का ये नहीं कि whether you are having knowledge of current affair or not, कोई मतलब नहीं होता इन चीजों का. Because hardly any time UPSC is going to ask a direct question from the current affair, ऐसा कुछ नहीं आता है. But how you are going to utilize that current affair in your especially mains answer writing. If you are not able to utilize that mains answer writing, no matter how much you are reading current affair, that does not going to work. So where you are going to apply, that is the important. तो यहाँ पे आपको इम्पोर्टेंट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. वन पैनल वाज द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ हेट स्पीच.
पैनल रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ हेट स्पीच.
सो अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट न्यूज वाज अनयूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ फंड्स. Which funds? MPLAD scheme. This. Another bill was public servant. This was in news. If you remember, Rajasthan bill to seal public servants. Okay, if any inquiry started, then good inquiry, what we need to do? Prior permission is required. Okay, same this Prevention of Corruption Act, there is also prior permission is required. Another important was law panel report on tribunals. So रिपोर्ट इन लॉ पैनल, रिपोर्ट ऑन ट्रिब्यूनल्स, बट हमको फोकस कहाँ पे रखना है? ट्रिब्यूनल पे, बिकॉज यहाँ से क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क्ड. देन एंटी टॉर्चर लेजिस्लेशन वाज इन न्यूज. And SC this e-samiksha. So these are the few important news that come in October, especially in this polity and Indian Constitution section. Correct. So this we are going to cover in our polity and constitution section. These are the major news. Some chota bullet type hoga that you can read on yourself. But these are the major. Especially we are discussing for mains purpose. So first is this panel recommendation on hate speech. Here in this panel, what was that committee? सबसे पहले हमको नाम याद रखने दो. What was the name of the committee that recommended on this hate speech? T.K. Vishwanathan committee. Correct. So committee was actually T.K. Vishwanathan. आपको इसका नाम जरूर ध्यान रखना है. Just whenever you are writing any question coming, especially regarding tolerance, this time they have asked question tolerance वाला. Intolerance, these things. So in that you can write easily the what recommendations by TK Viswanathan committee on hate speech was these recommendations. Even आप थोड़ा सा सिर्फ mention कर दोगे TK Viswanathan committee on hate speech was there, they have, and these recommendations must be accepted by the government. That's it. What was those recommendations? If you do not know, then also it is better. Instead of giving on recommendations, if you are just quoting that, there is a TK Viswanathan committee recommendation is there. Government need to follow those recommendations. That is fine answer in conclusion. Correct. So here again you need to use. Now what is hate speech? This, because that is the problem is happening in our India right now. Everyone is actually using this hate speech, especially those who are having constitutional post or they are ever high political post. For example, recently Lalu Prasad Yadav's son has used this hate speech language, and some other ruling parties also, they have used this hate speech language, especially in context of Padma movie. Correct. So that hate speech is what? So hate speech is incitement to hatred primarily against a group of person. So hate speech is what? Incitement of hatred against a group of person. Ki single person ke liye koi hate speech nahi hota hai. Correct. That will come some other, but any group of person or group of community, okay, that actually belongs to one racial, belongs to one ethnic, belongs to one caste. If you are entirely okay giving this incitement against them, that will be considered as hate speech. And hate speech can be in the form of both written as well as spoken words, sign as well as verbal, non-verbal, any form, that will be considered as hate speech. Like example, in social media we use too much hate speech right now because of this anonymity, no one able to follow you. That is why in Twitter and Facebook you can say anything. Correct. So for that already there is section 66A Act, 90 Act used to be there. But what about those who are giving speech? So that is the regarding this hate speech. Ab aisa nahi ki regarding hate speech we are not having any law. We are already having law. We are already having law regarding hate speech. But the thing is that those laws are not actually specifically targeting hate speech. They are very general in nature. First important aapka kya hoga? Related laws in India, hate speech. Article 19, जो सब लोग बोलते हैं freedom of expression, correct. But freedom of expression is not absolute. Okay, this freedom of expression, this is not absolute, but they are qualified in nature. That is. So for that, what is there? Article 19(2). What is this Article 19? Reasonable restrictions are there. So in constitution already has given, if someone in the name of hate speech is saying we are having freedom of expressions, correct, we are not actually going to do all these things, it just a one type of jumla, correct. So that is known as this, if reasonable restrictions are there under Article 19(2), okay, based on some grounds. What are those grounds? If you have covered quality,
morality, integrity,
okay, sovereignty and integrity of country, or morality, decency, or public order, contempt of the court, correct. So these are the grounds of defamation, incitement to an offense. All these are the grounds are available already in our constitution. Okay, you cannot claim that you are having freedom of expression. So according, but again this is not specifically targeting the hate speech, or iske liye if someone is going to Supreme Court or somewhere, it is a very difficult process. So this is one law that we are having in our Indian constitution. Another law that already we are having is IPC section 153. Already we are having section 153. So it is actually about promotes enmity between different groups. Okay, those who are promoting enmity between different groups by words, by sign, by spoken, anyway, on the grounds of groups, on the grounds of wahi sara ground jo article 14 mein aapke paas hai. Okay, kya kya hai? Caste, sex, place, religion, ethnic, race, all these जो आपको मन में आए, okay? So all these on that background, so यहाँ पे आपको जेल हो सकती है, इम्प्रिजमेंट इज देयर. अब हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ इयर्स इम्प्रिजमेंट इज देयर, डोंट ट्राई टू रिमेंबर, यू विल फॉरगेट. ओके, सो इसलिए जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल यहां पे अप टू 3 इयर्स, अब दैट थिंग्स यू शुड नॉट ट्राई टू रिमेंबर इफ एनी, अगर कहीं पे भी जाए, बिकॉज आपको कहीं मौका नहीं मिलने वाला है. दिस थिंग्स यू शुड यूज, ओनली थिंग यू शुड टू रिमेंबर दोज थिंग्स विच यू कैन गेट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू यूज देम. अब यहाँ पे promotes animity between different groups, just like that there is imprisonment is there, that's it. How many years imprisonment, we do not know. Even police wala person do not know these things, so that UPS is not expecting from us also. Another important that section is there, 295. This section we are having 295. So it is actually, the thing is this, malicious intention of outraging religious feelings. यहाँ पे है this section 295 in this malicious intention, correct, of outraging the religious feeling. For that means they should not try to break the religious sentiments. There are religious sentiments are there. For example, in the time of election, political parties, they use religion. Okay, polarization of election, that is actually against, because in Representative People's Act also section 295A, that is a criminal offense. Okay, your candidature can be suspended if you are using this. So already section 295, so hate speech against religious community also we use. Okay, one community for another community, so for that also already there is section is malicious intention of outraging religious feelings. Correct this. Or kahan pe, if someone is using this hate speech on internet, so for that already there is IT Act is there. Okay, IT Act 2002, जिसमें अलग पहले हुआ था सेक्शन 66A, जिससे बहुत प्रॉब्लम हुआ था कि someone is liking the Facebook post of some other person and that person was arrested actually. It started when Bala Sahab Thackeray was actually died, then two girls actually have liked the post and these two girls were arrested, and then one Ashim was, I don't know the name of that person has created the cartoon. Okay, and then in the cartoon he was arrested. Then in West Bengal, one professor was arrested in the when cartoon he made actually on the Mamata Banerjee. So these all what actually, and then share kar diya. So it is actually comes under this IT Act, because section 66A is there, arrest will be there. So that is why this section 66A now was removed, right? To avoid this so much of arrest. Okay, so still this IT Act is there. IT Act mein aapka this section 78 is there. Section 78, still it is protecting. If someone is actually using this hate speech, definitely punishment is there.
Sir, communalism is a form of hate speech?
Yes, definitely. That is also in hate speech. Means if you are using hate speech just to spread communalism, means that comes under this section 295A. Okay, malicious intention of outraging the religious feelings.
So it is not for normal individual.
Yes.
MPs
not MPs. Everyone. Thing is that when they use, then only we are able to hear. You also can use this hate speech, but all public will not come to know about you because you are not the famous person. But if you are suppose big person and then you are using this, okay, then definitely media will going to catch you. Like Azam Khan, whenever he thinks that media is not coming behind him, he used to give even a hate speech comment and then full media is behind him. Correct? So they actually maliciously intention is there. Okay, जब भी उनको लगता है दिस थिंग दे यूज्ड टू यूज. यस
सर, वेयर डू वी क्लासिफाई सेडिशन लॉ?
यस
सेडिशन लॉ,
यस सेडिशन लॉ इज डिफरेंट एक्चुअली, वो डिफरेंट है. सेडिशन लॉ इज दैट फॉर दैट कि इफ यू आर एक्चुअली आउटरेजिंग दिस सॉवरेनिटी और इंटीग्रिटी ऑफ द नेशन, देन ओनली इट विल बी एप्लीकेबल. Correct. But again, this is very long back when actually British were there. During that time, they found this sedition saying because we were actually going for independence of our nation. But now, see, one person, if you think that your nation is so weak that one person just creating cartoon can actually disturb full sovereignty integrity, how we are going to win against Pakistan then? Correct. So that is the thing. Seditious law are not good for democracy. Correct. So for already there is other law is there, you can carry those laws, but not seditious law. Like USA, Britain, that Britain has brought seditious law in India. In their own country, they are not having any seditious law. Correct? Next is, so already there are, these things are available, correct? But still these are not sufficient. That TK Viswanathan committee has observed that these laws are not sufficient. Correct? So for that, what he has recommended? So he has recommended that कि there should be a state cyber crime coordinator, because सबसे बड़ी problem है hate speech is simply viral होना. ठीक है, पहले क्या था, सोशल मीडिया जब नहीं था देन हेट स्पीच वाज लोकलाइज्ड इन नेचर ओनली. जहां पे हेट स्पीच दिया हुआ है देयर ओनली पीपल इज गोइंग टू बी इंपैक्टेड. बट नाउ द थिंग इज दैट हेट स्पीच इज गिवन इन एनी एरिया दैट इज गोइंग टू बी वायरल टू अनदर एरिया. सो इंपैक्ट बिकम्स पैन इंडिया इंपैक्ट. करेक्ट. सो दैट इज द रीजन इज इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज वी नीड टू एक्चुअली इंक्रीज अवर कैपेबिलिटी इन साइबर सिक्योरिटी. करेक्ट. सो स्टेट साइबर क्राइम कोऑर्डिनेटर, देयर शुड बी अ स्टेट साइबर क्राइम कोऑर्डिनेटर. एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट साइबर क्राइम सेल. दीज वर रिकमेंडेड बाई टी के विश्वनाथन कमेटी. He says that there should be section 153C also, because section 153 मैंने पढ़ा वहाँ पे था, it is not online speech, but online speech is covered under IT Act. But actually IT Act was not formulated just to prevent hate speech. IT Act का main objective क्या था? Just to increase the capacity building of IT sector, not to prevent these things. So that is the thing is, instead of we need to rely on IT sector, we need to add one more IT section, section 153C, to prohibit incitement through online. Incitement through online. Another thing is, hate speech should also be defined in very objective manner. Okay, hate speech actually may care, because that should not be misused by investigation agencies. Another term is, define hate speech in objective manner. And then put guidelines also. For investigative agencies. To avoid misuse of power. The problem यहीं पे, if you insert this section 153C, next day you see opposition parties, candidates will be arrested on the basis of, because hate speech तो family में भी हो जाती है ना, घर में, between siblings. अब आपने उसको seriously ले लिया ना, okay, then that person arrested. So इसीलिए क्या है कि misuse of power should be avoided, because whenever you are giving power to investigative agencies more, you need to take in care of that should not be misused. A misuse in the sense that arrest should not be based on simply by one police constable ne likh diya and that person is arrested. Means if you want to arrest, arrest warrant should come only through at least officer should be at the rank of DCP or ACP. अब एसीपी रैंक के जो ऊपर वाले ऑफिसर्स होते हैं डेफिनेटली दे आर नॉट वल्नरेबल इतना ज्यादा क्योंकि लोग कौन जाएगा लोकल पीपल ही जाएगा ना. अब ऐसा तो नहीं कि नरेंद्र मोदी इज गोइंग टू द ऑफिस टू फाइल एफआईआर. जो नरेंद्र मोदी का सबसे नीचे भक्त बैठा होगा ना एंड दैट इज अनएम्प्लॉयड पर्सन ही विल गोइंग टू अप्रोच एफआईआर के लिए. अब ही कैन नॉट अप्रोच एसीपी और डीसीपी लेवल ऑफिसर बिकॉज दे आर नॉट इम्प्टी देयर दे आर working something. But constable kya hai unke jaan pehchan ke hote hain, they are going to take FIR and that person will be arrested. But that person has put FIR not because he is not happy because he has said something against Narendra Modi. No, he is having his own personal enmity with that person and this is the chance. Correct. So that is the thing, is some guidelines must be given to investigation agency to misuse the avoid the misuse of power. Correct. Samajh mein aa gaya. So this thing we can use TK Viswanathan committee and then some section 153 295 ये article 192 हमेशा आपने हाथ में रखो. Okay, there are some reasonable restrictions are there and some अपने recommendation. Even suppose a question came कि you should actually provide your own recommendations how actually we need to avoid this situation of hate speech. Instead of naming that these recommendations were given by TK Viswanathan committee, you can give these recommendations on your own name because copyrights to hai nahi inke paas, theek hai na? Aur yahi akela aisa soch sakte hain, this is also, you also can think in the same manner. So, because when you are giving your own recommendations by thinking, or definitely you are not as mature to think in such a way. So, inke hi chaap do wahan pe answer mein, theek hai na? Aur examiner ko bhi itna pata nahi hota hai, theek hai? This thing because he's not preparing for IAS. Next comes question. This underutilization of MP-led schemes or MP-led funds. So first, सबसे पहले we need to know what is this MP-led. क्या है कि दिस अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन लाइक एग्जांपल इन हेमा मालिनी ऑल फाइव इन एमपी रेड स्कीम्स 5 करोड़ रुपीस आर गिवन टू ईच एंड एवरी एमपी ओके टू इन्वेस्ट फॉर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल डेवलपमेंट. अब हेमा मालिनी के अकाउंट में 5 करोड़ अभी भी पड़े हुए हैं करेक्ट बिकॉज़ शी इज नॉट हैविंग टाइम टू इन्वेस्ट दीस थिंग्स. सो दैट इज द अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन. प्रॉब्लम इज नॉट कि वी आर नॉट हैविंग फंड, प्रॉब्लम इज वी आर नॉट एबल टू invest those funds. For example, right now recently there was an RTI report was that in Delhi actually lot of pollution was there, around 794 crore rupees has been given to Delhi government to curb this pollution, but Delhi government has not invested or spent that money, only 200 crore rupees has spent, and then you are still crying that we are not having money. Whatever the money has been given, at least you need to spend that first. Correct. So apni Indian problem is this only, and that is why when this 14th Finance Commission has said that 32% से 42% now will be given to the state government. Main problem is to be here only कि state government has not that much of capability to absorb this extra fund. Whatever the fund they already having, they are not able to spend. And when we are giving extra fund, they definitely are not going to spend. And that is what they do, march us. Because क्या होता है कि fund is actually lapsable fund. If you are not able to spend that fund in the within period of time, it will again come back to the consolidated fund of India. So अपना जो financial है क्या होता है? 31st March. अब जैसे ही March में आते हैं 1st March, they are aware कि in their coffers lot of money is available. Okay, now only 1 month left. If you are not able to spend, full money again will go to the consolidated fund of India. So in this month only they are going to spend entire money. Okay, this is how the March rush happens. Correct. If they are not spending, then what will happen? In next time again you are going to ask for money, and then definitely finance minister will ask, when last year I have given you, you have not spent this money, why you are asking now? Correct. Then they cannot get the money. Same issue is there. MP-led scheme is there. So MP-led scheme was introduced in 1993. Again, not required to implement this thing. Okay. बस इतना है लोग 1990s में दिस स्कीम केम ओके अगेन नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर यूपीएससी पर्पस करेक्ट. अगर वो प्रीलिम्स में पूछ भी लिया, सपोज एग्जांपल किसी का सैडिस्ट था, उसने लिख दिया एम्पलीट स्कीम 19, डेफिनेटली वो आया तो आपको 1993 डायरेक्ट लिखेगा, बट ही इज नॉट गोइंग टू पुट लाइक 1994 और 1992. ये मॉक टेस्ट में होता है बस. देखिए यूपीएससी में नेवर एवर, आइदर दे आर गोइंग टू पुट यू 1985 या 2005 या 1993, दैट्स इट. इतना वेरिएशन रखते हैं, करेक्ट. स्टेट लेवल एग्जाम में वेरिएशन ऐसा ही होता है कि 1993.5 है ना. सो अवॉइड दिस. इन यूपीएससी स्कीम स्टार्टेड इन 1993. और आपको ध्यान कर देते हैं, फॉर एवरी स्कीम यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, विच इज द मिनिस्ट्री दैट इज इम्प्लीमेंटेबल मिनिस्ट्री, विच मिनिस्ट्री इज इम्प्लीमेंटिंग दिस स्कीम. ये आपको एवरी स्कीम का पता होना जरूरी है, स्पेशली दो फ्लेक्सिबल स्कीम्स. जो फ्लेक्सिबल स्कीम्स होती है ना, फ्लेक्सिबल इस स्कीम का आपको डेफिनेटली यू नीड टू रिमेंबर विच मिनिस्ट्री इज इंप्लीमेंटिंग दैट. ओके, सो विच मिनिस्ट्री इज इंप्लीमेंटिंग दिस एम्पलीट स्कीम? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक एंड प्रोग्राम इंप्लीमेंटेशन. This ministry is implementing this scheme. And this scheme is centrally sponsored scheme. Okay, there are two types of scheme is, एक centrally sponsored scheme, another is centrally sector scheme. What is the difference between these two? एक centrally sponsored scheme, एक है centrally, क्या था?
Central
sector scheme. दोनों में difference क्या है? See, both centrally sponsored scheme and centrally sector scheme, both are actually 100% financed by center. एक, ठीक है ना? But centrally sponsored scheme will be implemented by state machinery. Centrally sector scheme will be implemented by central machinery. This is the difference. Centrally sponsored scheme and centrally sector scheme, both are financed 100% by the center only. Only difference is in implementation. A sponsored scheme will be implemented by state, and this scheme implemented by central machinery. Correct? करेक्ट इज, ये चीज समझ में आ गया डिफरेंस दोनों में, सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड एंड सेंट्रली सेक्टर स्कीम. नाउ इन दिस स्कीम रुपीस 5 crore आर गिवन पर एनम. ओके, अर्लियर वर 1 crore रुपीस पर एनम, देन इट वाज इंक्रीज टू 5 crore रुपीस पर एनम. दैट मींस 1 MP विल बी हैविंग 25 crore रुपीस, ओके, टू स्पेंड फॉर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वर्क्स. And that is also non-lapsable. This is the issue actually. Because when it is non-lapsable and you are not spending, still this money will remain with you. Right? This money will remain with you. And it's better if this money is going back and then government of India is putting in the bank. At least government of India can earn some saving interest rates. But yahan pe to it is just costly. Money is available and that money can be utilized in some other schemes. अब सो एक एमपी 5 years 25 crore रुपीस आ गया नॉन लैप्सेबल. अब सो सेम थिंग इज डन बाय सपोज एटलीस्ट 10 MPs, दे आर नॉट वर्किंग, देन टोटली हाउ मेनी 250 crore रुपीस. 250 crore रुपीस इज इनफ मनी, ओके, टू एनहांस द कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ मोर देन 25 विलेजेस. करेक्ट, सो दिस इज द इशू इज कि रुपीस 5 करोड़ पर है ना, एंड इज आल्सो नॉन लैप्सेबल कि इवन दो दे आर नॉट स्पेंडिंग स्टिल दैट मनी विल रिमेन देयर ओनली. This money is not actually with MP. ऐसा नहीं है कि the MPs are having in their own account. This money will be in this district administration, okay? District collector's account, okay? This money will be in district collector's account, district administration account. Only work डन बाय एमपी क्या है, एमपी इज गोइंग टू सजेस्ट टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कि यहाँ पे वन हैंडपंप इज रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज ऑलरेडी सनी देवल है रिमूव दैट हैंडपंप. Okay, so that way actually district administration is going to invest that money there. District administration cannot invest that money on his own. Request will come from MP. Clear? तो ऐसा भी मत सोचो ना यहाँ पे corruption हो सकता है because money is here. Decision making authority is here. Correct? Both are different here.
So the MP have to take permission from someone?
No. Only thing is they need to take care of कि इन देयर नॉन पर्सन फैमिली मेंबर्स किन देयर दैट मनी शुड नॉट गो. करेक्ट. सो ओनली प्रॉब्लम इज दिस, अदरवाइज दे कैन इन्वेस्ट एनीवेयर. एंड उसमें भी ये है कि जो 5 करोड़ रुपीस पर एनम दे आर इन्वेस्टिंग, इसमें 15% फॉर एससी एंड 75% फॉर एसटी. यस यस, डेफिनेटली याद नहीं रखना है, सम टाइम्स दे कैन आस्क, इसमें डिफिकल्टी भी नहीं है. देखिए सेम है, 15% रिजर्वेशन है बेस्ड ऑन पॉपुलेशन, 7.5 रिजर्वेशन एसटी बेस्ड ऑन पॉपुलेशन. आपको इतना यस देयर इज समथिंग दैट इज एससी एंड एसटी रिलेटेड थिंग्स इज देयर, परसेंटेज डोंट वरी. वन मोर थिंग, यूपीएससी कभी परसेंटेज नहीं देने वाला है. ओके, सिंपली बोलेंगे देयर आर सम रिजर्वेशन इज देयर फॉर एससी एंड एसटी, दैट्स इट, इतना ही. What about if suppose in their constituency there is no tribal area, where there are various areas are there, okay, in the constituency no tribal area is there, then in other constituency they can spend that money. So it is also an issue actually. Why that MP should spend that money in another constituency when that person is not voter? This is the drawback of this scheme. Correct? Because suppose example if you are an MP in Delhi, there is no tribal area. अब दैट पर्सन नीड टू एक्चुअली सर्च ट्राइबल एरिया, सो सर्च करने के लिए उसको आना पड़ेगा झारखंड, बिकॉज कंप्लीट उत्तर प्रदेश देयर इज नो ट्राइबल एरिया. कम टू बिहार, बिहार में नो ट्राइबल एरिया नाउ, कम टू झारखंड, इतना मनी खर्च हो गया उसको ढूंढते ढूंढते. ठीक है ना, तो इसीलिए दिस इज द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ दिस स्कीम. करेक्ट, दिस शुड नॉट बी डन.
ही कैन डिस्कस इन पार्लियामेंट, राइट?
यस,
अदर एमपी.
They are not discussing even good things. You are asking about this. And whenever anything means you, money will be utilized, then district administration will issue utilization certificate to state government. Okay, whenever money will be spent over any work, the utilization certificate will be issued to the state government by district administration, and then definitely this certificate will be sent to the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So what is MP led scheme? ये हमको पता चल गया. Now comes to what is the issue, problem क्या है scheme में? Correct? So these are the issue. What is this MP? Same way there is a MLA led scheme is also there. Like MP के लिए MLA led scheme, right? So this is member of parliament local area development. This is member of legislative assembly local area development. Correct? ऐसे वन मोर स्कीम बाद दिस संसद आदर्श योजना, इफ यू रिमेंबर. ओके, देयर वाज वन स्कीम बाद सेम लाइक दिस आदर्श योजना, आदर्श ग्राम योजना, संसद आदर्श,
संसद आदर्श.
यस,
जहां पे एमपी को एक मेजर पीरियड ड्राफ्ट करना पड़ता
है. यस, डेफिनेटली सेम. सो ये भी एक स्कीम, नरेंद्र मोदी जी इटली ब्रॉट दिस स्कीम संसद आदर्श ग्राम योजना. यू नीड टू अडॉप्ट वन विलेज इन योर कंस्टिट्यूएंसी एंड बाई 2019 यू नीड टू अडॉप्ट थ्री विलेजेस बाई 2024. ओके, बिकॉज ही नो दैट ही इज गोइंग टू बी इन इलेक्शन. ओके, सो देयर एट. ओके, अगेन फाइव मोर द टोटल एट विलेज यू नीड टू अडॉप्ट, बट मनी कहीं नहीं दिया गया है ना. ओनली यू नीड टू अडॉप्ट देम. मनी कहाँ से लाओगे? मनी वट एवर द एम पी लेड स्कीम इज देयर from here, whatever other government scheme is there, from that whatever the money is required, there only you need to invest. No extra money has been given.
And that is good enough.
Yes.
By this way they are also utilized.
Yes, this money you can utilize MP led wala. Other jo government schemes hai, Pradhan Mantri Sadak Rozgar Yojana se you have created, built sadak kuch, drinking water yojana, this Grameen Vidyutikaran Yojana, different yojanas are there. So that you can utilize that, correct? So this is Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana is also there to implement of the village, to create a model village. So issue kya hai isme? Issue is this corruption and misappropriation. Main issue is here, issue of corruption and misappropriation. Misappropriation of money. Because whenever we are doing work in this MP-led scheme, say that work you cannot give to the private contractor. Aapko nal lagwana hai, that should be given to government contractor only. Private contractors are not allowed in such a work. But what they do? They give the work to the private contractor. That is not permitted in this scheme. A private contractor kaun hoga? Non-person hi hoga. Correct? This is the issue of corruption and misappropriation. Another issue is unutilization. Complete money is lying there. There are more than 100 MPs are there. They have not invested a single rupee in entire year. So, unutilization of or underutilization of funds. This is another issue. Even though they are having money, but they are not able to spend. Another issue that they are facing. Absence of monitoring. Okay, no monitoring is there. Regular monitoring reports are not there. Still there is utilization certificate is issued by the DA, but still there is no monitor whether that is working yet or not. Only 1 year, 1 day ke liye photo session ke liye you have created and after that there is nothing. So ye problem hai. Another problem is separation of power. What is the separation of power issue? Separation of power, definitely you know ki executive ka work kya hai? Executive work karna. Legislator ka hai to enact legislation. Judiciary work is there to interpret. Okay, so MP ye kaun se log hai? Legislator or executive?
Legislator.
And developmental work is legislative work or executive work? So this legislature is doing executive work. There is an affection of this impact over the separation of power. Correct?
But with the help of administrative office.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, that is the Supreme Court in 2010 said that the actual work done by district administration, not by MP. That is why it's because this case actually went to the Supreme Court for the constitutionality of this scheme. And then in 2010, Supreme Court ruled that actual work is done by executive organs only, not by MPs. Correct? For example, done by municipality, done by panchayat, done by district administration, not by MP himself or herself. That is why there is no issue of separation of power. So you can quote this also. In 2010, Supreme Court ruled that actual work is done by executive organs only, municipality, panchayat, district administration. Or issue concern, absence of people's participation. This is another issue which this scheme is facing. So these are the issues, basically 5 issues are there in this scheme. Absence of people's participation, there is a lack of information with MP ki in which area what peoples are required. Usme kaha tha, those who are very close to the MP, they used to get work done, but those local areas, those are not having slum areas, they are not able to reach towards the MP, so their work is not going to be fulfilled. So lack of people's participation is there. Correct? So what are the measures kya le sakte hain isko acha karne ke liye? जो चीज बुरी है उसी को बदल दो, ठीक है ना. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल वॉट वी कैन डू, सर्वेस कैन बी कंडक्टेड. ओके, वॉट वी कैन डू फॉर दिस, the measures we can take is surveys need to be undertaking for assessment of need of constituents. For assessment the need of constituents we can carry out surveys ki jitna constituency hai usme survey kar lo, in which areas what thing is required, according to that survey need to be presented to the MP and then MP will issue the work. Correct, the survey need to be done.
Survey ke liye paisa lagega?
Yes.
सर्वे के लिए आल्सो इट नीड मनी.
एंड देयर पार्टी कार्यकर्ता इज देयर ना, यस्टरडे आई मीन साहब वाज सेइंग दैट देयर पार्टी कार्यकर्ता इज वर्किंग 15 आवर्स. ओके, सो व्हाट इज करेक्ट, सर्वे कैन बी डन इजीली. म्युनिसिपैलिटीज पंचायत्स आर देयर, दे कैन प्रोवाइड योर बॉटम टॉप अप्रोच इंस्टेड ऑफ टॉप टू डाउन अप्रोच. वी कैन कंडक्ट सर्वे. अनदर थिंग वी कैन डू, लोकल कम्युनिटी का इन्वॉल्वमेंट में नहीं, एब्सेंस ऑफ लोकल प्रदेश. सो लोकल कम्युनिटी शुड बी इन्वॉल्वड इन द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ पब्लिक एसेट्स, बिकॉज़ अपने आप प्रॉब्लम है कि मेंटेनेंस एसेट्स भी क्रिएट इजिली. ऐसा नहीं गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट स्पेंडिंग मनी या टॉयलेट अभी से आया. आई रिमेंबर टॉयलेट पहले भी था, ऐसा पहले भी टॉयलेट स्कीम थी एंड दे यूज टू क्रिएट बिल्ड टॉयलेट्स, कम्युनिटी टॉयलेट इन द विलेज, नॉट इवन ईच इन इंडिविजुअल. हाउ मेनी डेज दे यूज टू वर्क, कितने भी दिन नहीं, बिकॉज फ्री टॉयलेट्स वर देयर, जो सबसे पहले जाएगा वही कर पाएगा. उसके बाद 10 डेज आफ्टर देर इज नो टॉयलेट एक्चुअली, बिकॉज मेंटेनेंस ऑफ पब्लिक एसेट इज नॉट देयर. सो लोकल कम्युनिटी को ये वर्क देना चाहिए ना, लोकल कम्युनिटी शुड बी गिवन फॉर द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ पब्लिक एसेट. करेक्ट, सो वी आर ऑल्सो हैविंग दिस प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज विदाउट पीपुल्स पार्टिसिपेशन वी कैन नॉट टेक, बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट इन मीन्स पुट वन पर्सन ईच एंड एवरी पब्लिक एसेट. Until except you are creating this actually sentiment among the people, whatever the work is like railway, आपकी संपत्ति है, फिर भी कोई नहीं तोड़ रहा है ना, लेकिन एक sentiment बढ़ गया, ये आपकी संपत्ति है, still you are not creating. But अगर कोई public asset कर दिया, there is they have not written it is your property, still you are hurting that. Correct. So same thing here we can create behavioral economics. Correct. Next thing we can do, impact assessment study we need to do. Impact assessment study. Correct? Impact assessment study. Another issue क्या था? इसमें एक issue था, this underutilization of funds. So इसमें क्या है कि non-lapsable है, तो उनको problem भी नहीं है. Because it is non-lapsable, it will remain there. That is why they become too lazy. If suppose it lapsable ban jaye, ki every year it will go again back, then definitely they are going to spend this money. So then what we can do? We can make this lapsable. Instead of non-lapsable, we can create that lapsable. So that fund at least we can utilize in other schemes.
So how about implementing social audit?
Yes. Yeah, definitely you can implement this. People's participation in social audit, you can definitely you can put over there also. We can conduct social audits also. Social audit is financial audit plus social societies are involved over there. That is social audit. So financial audit hota hai. Financial audit mein kya hota hai? Ki jo CAG hota hai, CAG. Okay, Auditor General. What they do? Ki they say actually two things. Suppose if there is one work A is there. For that work, suppose rupees 100 has been allocated. They are going to check whether this rupees 100 is going to be allocated or not. First thing, if they are allocated, whether they are allocated to work A or not. If they are allocated for work A, whether work A is actually aaya ki nahi, that's it. Isse zyada they are not going to check. But in social audit, kya hota hai? Ki yahan pe CAG work kar rahe hain. Yahan pe kya hoga? Those are the beneficiaries, the stakeholders. They themselves check this. How much money you have spent actually, and that money was for that work or not, and whether that work has been created or not, whether there is outcome is there or not, not output, outcome also. Output and outcome make a difference. Suppose example for education, output is this, suppose 300 crore rupees has been given to build the school, aapne school ki building khadi kar di, that is output. But in that building mein, school mein, whether there has actually एनिमल हस्बेंड्री आप कर रहे हो या बिकॉज चिल्ड्रंस आर कमिंग टू टेक सम एजुकेशन. ओके, दैट इज नॉट इज आउटकम. सो आउटकम इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट कम्पेयर टू आउटपुट. सो दे आर गोइंग टू चेक इवन आउटकम. आपने रोड बनवा दिया, वेदर दिस इज रोड इज मोटरेबल रोड और नॉट, नहीं तो कच्चा रोड है फिर, देयर इज नो लॉजिक. सो दैट इज सोशल ऑडिट. सोशल ऑडिट नाउ कम्स इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में भी आ गया, लोकल पंचायत हमने पढ़ा था आर्टिकल नंबर 243 जी करके, सोशल ऑडिट इज देयर, तो सोशल ऑडिट इज कंपलसरी इन मनरेगा नाउ, करेक्ट? सो सोशल ऑडिट आल्सो वी कैन क्रिएट हियर आल्सो. और क्या कर सकते हैं कि दिस एमपीलैड स्कीम में व्हाट एवर द वर्क हैज बीन डन इट इज वेरी आइसोलेटेड इन नेचर, वी डू नॉट नो कि कहां पे रिक्वायरमेंट है, वेयर नो रिक्वायरमेंट स्टिल वी आर स्पेंडिंग दैट मनी. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, वी कैन पुट दिस एमपीलैड स्कीम इन ब्रॉडर डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल डेवलपमेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. पढ़ा था उसमें डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्लानिंग कमेटी, एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पर देयर इज अ प्लानिंग कमेटी यूज्ड टू बी देयर. And that planning committee is creating planning work. So, us planning work mein where is requirement, we can actually put this MPLAD in the context of this. Jahan pe jo bhi requirement hogi planning ki, that money we can spend here. Okay? So, the thing is to locate this MPLAD in the broader context of district level development.
But MPs will not allow that.
MPs are not allowing that, but we need to do. Okay? Because we are writing answer, we know anything is not going to be related. Okay? ऐसा कोई भी चीज नहीं होने वाले. समझ में आ गया एमपीलैड, बिल्कुल समझ में आ गया. एमपीलैड स्कीम केम इन 1993 इस मिनिस्ट्रीज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इंप्लीमेंटेशन स्कीम. दिस इज ए नॉन लैप्सेबल, करेक्ट? 5 crore rupees पर ईयर एंड इट इज नॉट एक्चुअली एमपी इज गोइंग टू स्पेंड दैट मनी, ही इज यूज्ड टू suggest the work to the district administration. The district administration usually used to be work over there. What is the problem? Problem is underutilization of fund is there. Or problem kya hai? Maintenance bhi nahi hai, local participation bhi nahi hai, and this lapsable bhi hai, and issue of corruption and misappropriation is there. These are the issue. Aur uske problems kaise solve hui? Already we have done. Now next come to this law pehle about tribunals. सो लॉ पैनल ऑन ट्रिब्यूनल्स, सबसे पहले भी क्या
सर प्रीवियस कैन बी राइट लाइक मॉनिटरिंग इश्यूज
आपको ये लॉ कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया क्या है, वेदर इज स्टैचुरी बॉडी, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी, और कौन सी बॉडी है वो आपको पता करना है. ओके, तो ये बात पता करना है पहले. दिस लॉ कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया, इसका ओरिजिन कहाँ पे है, एंड इट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी और स्टैचुरी बॉडी. ओके, और एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एक्स्ट्रा स्टैचुरी ये पता करना है. So it is not a constitutional body at all because it is not present in constitution. Cool. Right? क्या? हाँ. So ऐसा नहीं कि unconstitutional body है. There is a difference between unconstitutional and extra constitutional. Correct? So सबसे पहले आते हैं कि what is this tribunal? Tribunal क्या है? These tribunals actually they are present in our Indian Constitution. Okay, especially up in Article number. These two articles are there. They were added in 42nd Amendment because आपको मालूम है A and B they are putting over there. These are amendment. So it was given in 42nd Amendment. Okay, for 323 it is for CAT. Okay, Central Administrative Tribunal. 323A for CAT, that is Central Administrative Tribunal, and this 323B for rest of others. Like for example, for tax ke liye there is one tribunal is there, consumer courts ke liye one tribunal is there, different tribunal that will be work under 323B. But it is CAT. CAT program kya hota hai? If any service condition mein problem hogi, suppose you are IAS officer, you are not happy with the service condition, someone is not given to leave you, promotion, you are thinking that promotion is not correct. So whatever you are having grievances, that grievances you can means redress in CAT, Centrally Administrative Tribunal. Instead of going to the court, you can go to the CAT. Here your grievance will be redressed. So for that it is a 323. So 323 is especially for central officers or All India Service, and this is for state level. Correct. So this tribunal jo hota hai, ye tribunal work kya hai iska? Definitely there is some dispute is there, to redress that dispute. So it is a judicial body. This is a judicial body because it is redressing something, but it is not High Court and Supreme Court, so we cannot call exactly a judiciary body. So what we can call that? Quasi judicial body. Work is to wahi hai, to redress the dispute, but it is not actually High Court or District Court.
But its judgment are bound.
Yes, judgments are bound, definitely. Correct. But they can be appealed also in another court. So it becomes a quasi judicial body. Why quasi judicial body? If whatever the suppose you catch, okay, Central Administrative Tribunal, this tribunal will be added by not all judges, but there will be a mix of judicial members as well as administrative members. That is why it becomes not entire judicial but quasi, because administrative members are also there. So this tribunals is had tribunals mein kya hoga, two members honge, judicial member plus administrative member, both are going to hear your problem, because this whosoever will going to approach tribunals, their only work will be, domain will be expertise in nature, or judiciary or the judiciaries are not expertise in nature. Their expertise is only one, that is law, but not in other matters. That is why there is expertise is available in the form of administrative member, because these are those members who have worked in that particular area. So expertise has been given, and since it also belongs to law, that is why one judicial members are also there. Correct. So the thing is this, it is actually, suppose this is judiciary and this is executive. Suppose kisi department ki problem hai, that problem can be solved by executive only, administrative member only, or it can be solved here only, but we require both. That is why it comes here in between, neither judiciary nor executive, but in between. So isliye kuch member yahan se le liye, kuch member yahan se le liye, hybrid. Correct. So that is tribunals. Tribunal of samajh mein aa gaya, right? So it was a necessity. Like for example, motor vehicles act hai. Ab motor vehicles act mein kya hai ki there is requirement of nitty gritty of this motor vehicles act. Ab judges are not expert in this domain, so for that we require one tribunal on that. नहीं तो जजमेंट में क्या था, चालान वालान कटता है, आप जाते हो वहाँ पे, पहले तो चालान काटता ही नहीं है कोई, ठीक है, कट भी गया सपोज चालान, तो सब एक साथ खड़े हो जाते हैं कटघरे में एंड गो, ओके, दोज हु आर इन फेवर से आए, दोज हु आर ना आए एंड देन पास. सो इन सच में दोज हु आर रेडी टू पे 100 rupees, ओके, तो 100 rupees अब कौन बोलेगा, कौन आगे जाए, ठीक है 100 rupees वी आर पेइंग, देन एवरी चालान इज गोइंग टू बी कैंसिल फिनिश. सो इन सच में दे आर डूइंग in district courts. So to avoid these things, we are having such, because administrative expertise will be available. Correct. Ek hi samajh mein aaya tribunals hota kya hai. So it is just an effective mechanism to reduce the burden of judiciary, because if this is not available, then we need to go to the judiciary. So we are reducing the burden of judiciary. This was one actually important objective to set up this tribunals. Correct. And these tribunals actually work on the basis of principle of natural justice. These tribunals work on the principle of natural justice and not according to the civil procedure of court and criminal procedure of court. These judiciary, High Court and Supreme Court, District Court, they work according to civil procedure code and criminal procedure code. But tribunals never work according to civil procedure code and criminal procedure code. They work on the basis of principle of natural justice. What is the principle of natural justice? no one will be the judge in his own case. That is natural justice, yahi to hua na. No one will be the judge in his own case. No person will be given punishment two times for the same offense. This is the natural justice, correct or not? Proper opportunity will be given to the party. That is natural justice. So these actually work based on principle of natural justice. Correct? Since it works based on principle of natural justice, that is why it is easier to understand by everyone. You are taking yahan pe aapko lawyer ki zarurat nahi hai. You can actually plead your own opinion on your way. You do not require any law, because yahan pe legal language is not there. Only language, principle of natural justice, simple language is there, so anyone can understand. That is why it will become less costly. Correct? So for that tribunals, there was Administrative Tribunals Act was came. Administrative Tribunal Act 1985. This question ek baar pehle se pucha tha. This Administrative Tribunal Act 1985 came during which Prime Minister? Option 1 here, Jawaharlal Nehru, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Morarji Desai, राजीव गांधी. अब जिसको मालूम होता 1985 में उस समय राजीव गांधी थे, ही कैन आंसर इजीली. दैट वाज द क्वेश्चन. करेक्ट. प्रीलिम्स में पूछा था, वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, बट एट दैट टाइम ओनली टफ था. ठीक है, बिकॉज दे वर नॉट रीडिंग दिस मच. सो दिस वाज एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ट्रिब्यूनल्स एक्ट 1985 ड्यूरिंग राजीव गांधी राइट के मैन. अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट दिस सेंट्रली एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ट्रिब्यूनल्स वाज एक्सेप्टेड. Correct. अब issue ये था कि when this administrative tribunals came, administrative tribunals act 1923A, 1923B, the problem was कि here actually you can suppose यहाँ पे whatever the judgment will come, judgment. If suppose you are not happy with that judgment, then you can directly go to the Supreme Court. Means High Court was completely bypassed. High Court was completely bypassed. Only you can approach to the Supreme Court. That's it. So इससे क्या हो कि High Court is actually अवॉइड विद दिस बर्डन. नहीं तो फिर हाई कोर्ट में जाओ, फिर वही चीज शुरू हो जाए. करेक्ट. सो हाई कोर्ट वॉज अवॉइडेड हियर. ओनली डायरेक्टली यू कैन लीव टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट. सो द थिंग हैपेंस यहाँ पे टू इम्पॉर्टेंट केसेस इज देयर, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केसेस. आपको ये केस के नाम भी ध्यान रखना है. टू इम्पॉर्टेंट केसेस वॉज, वन केस वॉज एस पी संपत कुमार केस. This SP Sampath Kumar case. इसमें एक्चुअली इशू क्या रहा था कि यू आर कंप्लीटली रिप्लेसिंग हाई कोर्ट एंड यू आर क्रिएटिंग ट्रिब्यूनल्स. सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, ट्रिब्यूनलाइजेशन ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन स्टार्टेड. करेक्ट. अब इन दिस ट्रिब्यूनल्स द अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ जुडिशियल मेंबर्स, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव मेंबर्स, हु आर डूइंग government. Correct. And any issue that happens here, that may one party is gone hai? Government. Because if you are not happy with service condition, that means you are going to fight against government, not against Sri Lanka. Correct. So one party is government, and government is also appointing these members. This is principle of natural justice. This principle of natural justice is you cannot become judge in his own case. Your state is judge in his own case. Okay. So yahan pe first thing, yahan pe Supreme Court says that ki some measures you need to take care. Because if you are giving this judicial work to these tribunals, then you need to equate them with judiciary in the form of making them independent, and autonomy need to be given. Independency and autonomy need to be given. This thing was asked in S.P. Sampath Kumar case. Correct this, but still High Court is bypassed. Still High Court is bypassed. Only directly you can move to the Supreme Court. Then फिर भी कोई अनएम्प्लॉयड था, उसको मजा नहीं आया. ठीक है ना. देन उसने जाता लक्ष्मीकांत पार्टी, उसको याद आया कि इस आर्टिकल नंबर 226 इज देयर, क्योंकि यू कैन अप्रोच टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट बिकॉज देयर इज आर्टिकल नंबर 32 इज देयर, 32 बिकम बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर, सो यू कैन नॉट अवॉइड सुप्रीम कोर्ट इन केस ऑफ जुडिशरी. देन वो बोला कि हमने तो यह भी पढ़ा था ना क्लास नोट्स में, 226 is also there, then how you can avoid High Court also, because High Court is also comes under 226 basic structure of the Constitution, and that thing you cannot bypass. So instead of directly you are moving to the Supreme Court, you need to move through High Court and then only Supreme Court. And that case was L. Chandrakumar or L. C. Kumar case. Okay? So this jurisdiction of High Court cannot be explored. So जो article number 323 जो 823, इसमें एक था, इसका 2D and 323B 3D. These two articles were there. These two articles में they are actually empowering the Parliament to explore the jurisdiction of High Court. So उन्होंने बोला remove these articles. You cannot exclude the jurisdiction of High Court because it comes under article 226. This is the basic structure of the constitution. So इसलिए whatever the judgment will come, that directly actually going to appeal for in High Court in division bench, not single bench, but division bench में जाएगा.
What is division bench?
Division bench means when bench is having two judges. अब ऐसा नहीं सिंगल जज इज नॉट, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे जज था तो उसकी भी मान मर्यादा रखी जाए, ठीक है, क्योंकि वो जज वहीं से आया है. सो इसलिए इट लाइ टू द डिवीजन बेंच. सो थिंग वाज दिस, अपना मेन मुद्दा क्या था ट्रिब्यूनल का, टू अवॉइड द बर्डन ऑन द हाई कोर्ट सुप्रीम कोर्ट, व्हाट एक्चुअली वी हैव डन. Because जब भी जजमेंट आएगा बिटवीन टू पार्टीज स्टेट एंड अदर, इफ वन इज नॉट हैप्पी इट विल अगेन गो टू द हाई कोर्ट, जहां से शुरू किए थे वहीं पे आ गए फिर से, ठीक है. सो दिस वाज द इशू, करेक्ट. अब इशू क्या है ट्रिब्यूनल्स के, इशू ये है कि ट्रिब्यूनल्स में फर्स्ट इज इशू देयर इज नो इंडिपेंडेंसी, बिकॉज मेनी ट्रिब्यूनल्स दे वर्क्स अंडर द डिपार्टमेंट, सेम डिपार्टमेंट जहाँ पे इशू स्टार्ट होता है, लाइक इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट, अपीलेट ट्रिब्यूनल्स अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ दिस फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री. अब फाइनेंस इनकम टैक्स इशू कहाँ पे आएगा, अगेंस्ट फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री, एंड दैट फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री इज गिविंग हिज ओन ट्रिब्यूनल टू यू, करेक्ट. दिस इज द अगेंस्ट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नेचुरल जस्टिस. So thing is that there is not independency and autonomy as much as available in case of High Court and Supreme Court. Because in High Court and Supreme Court, judges are actually appointed by President, but on the recommendation of judiciary itself. But here the appointment is done by executive only. Correct. So this one issue is happening. Independence and autonomy is not there. Correct. First. Second issue is this. This led to the actually despotism in the sense autocratic ruler, because you are having executive power also, now you are having judicial power also, and then there is also one thing that you have delegated legislation. Delegated legislation kya hai? कि इन स्केलेटन फॉर्म ऑफ पार्लियामेंट और लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली दे यूज्ड टू प्रोवाइड द लॉ एंड देन द फिलिंग डन बाय द एग्जीक्यूटिव. फॉर एग्जांपल देयर इज मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट इज देयर, बट देयर इज मोटर व्हीकल रूल्स इज आल्सो देयर, बट रूल्स आर नॉट क्रिएटेड बाय लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली और पार्लियामेंट, दे आर क्रिएटेड बाय एग्जीक्यूटिव. सो दैट मींस यू आर हैविंग लेजिस्लेटिव पावर आल्सो, यू आर हैविंग नाउ जुडिशियल पावर आल्सो, यू आर हैविंग एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑलरेडी, ऑल द थ्री ऑर्गन्स इन वन सिंगल पर्सन, दैट इज व्हाट despotism. You are creating a new despotism. So there is no separation of power. All power in the hands of one person. Correct? other issue kya tha, there are a lot of pendency of the cases was in high court was there earlier. Abhi bhi high court mein aur supreme court mein total sare court mein 3 crore cases are in pending, itna apne devta bhi nahi hai, theek hai na, itna cases are pending. So that we want to avoid this situation, that is why we have created tribunals. But yahan pe bhi more than 94% of cases are pending, there is no quick justice is available. So whenever we are actually checking anything, whether it is successful or not, we need to actually check on the basis of objectives. What were the objective to create this? But objectives are not fulfilled. So there is also a lot of pending cases are available still there. No quick justice is available. Okay, no quick justice is available.
Sir, first one we have a problem with despotism.
What
was
the first one? I don't know. Yes?
Independence.
Independence and autonomy is not there. But उसके लिए आपका आर्टिकल नंबर 264 इज देयर ना, बट दैट इज डिफरेंट ट्रिब्यूनल्स, बट दैट दे आर सेम जस्ट, बट दिस विल कम अंडर 223
बी
बी.
सो अकॉर्डिंग टू जजमेंट दैट हाई कोर्ट शुड नॉट बी बाईपास्ड.
यस, बट उसके लिए ऑलरेडी देयर इज आर्टिकल 264 में लिख दिया गया है ना, सो वी हैव नॉट रिमूव्ड दैट थिंग, वी हैव रिमूव्ड ओनली 323 ए का 2D and 323 3 का 3D, करेक्ट. So that is the thing, exclude, we cannot exclude the jurisdiction, but in that case we can.
High court can be bypassed.
Yes, definitely. Correct, because that is interstate. So interstate mein original appellate is available to
Supreme Court
only. Correct, because that is a federal matter. So here is, so what we need to do, or kya issue hai, ki accessibility is also less. Because main problem Supreme Court ka kya hai? What is the main issue of Supreme Court? Supreme Court exists only in Delhi. If some person want to come from Madras and go to the Delhi from Chennai, definitely it is very difficult for that person. First apne yahan se lawyer karke aao, fir uska bhi paisa do, fir 3 to 4 days journey karke aao. It is very, instead of that he is going to accept his defeat. Correct. So for that what we need to be geographically available on the tribunals. But these tribunals are also not geographically available each and every area. They are also scant geographic availability. They are available only in few metro cities, that's it. Another issue is, when appeal actually lies to the Supreme Court kis cheez ke liye, main motto of Supreme Court is what? Main motto, jo main sabse important work Supreme Court ka hai, what is the main work of Supreme Court?
Safeguarding fundamental rights.
Yes?
Safeguarding fundamental rights.
Safeguarding fundamental rights?
Constitution.
Constitution ka interpretation karna, interpretation of the Constitution. But aapne kaam kaun sa de diya? Chalan wala usko. ठीक है ना, that is the another issue is कि Supreme Court should not this last resort of this work, this final nuances that can be undertaken by High Court. If you are not even accepting the judgment coming from High Court, then remove those judges. Otherwise, you are considering that those judges are not competent. That is why you are moving to the Supreme Court again. Correct. If you are considering that High Court judges are not competent, then remove all High Courts. So another issue is having over there this. The Supreme Court just hearing appeals from tribunals, they under actually this, they actually reduce the time available to the Supreme Court for interpretation of the Constitution. So you can write this thing also. The Supreme Court that is hearing appeals, Supreme Court that is hearing appeals from tribunals would have to deal with finer nuances, would have to deal with finer nuances of disputes.
that could be good.
Under a specialized area of law. Under a specialized area of law. Under a specialized area of law. Correct. Because we require expertise, but Supreme Court is not having this expertise. Correct. That is why we have created administrative law. And they are hearing those cases which are require expertise in different area instead of law area. So that is why they are going to undermine Supreme Court. Correct? अब इस क्या इसको कैसे we can improve terminals, कैसे improve कर सकते हैं? First important thing is qualification of judges. That we need to do here is कि जो members, those who are going to become this part of tribunals, they should have expertise akin to the judges. Okay, they should have expertise akin to the judges. Mean they should have qualification equal to the judges at least.
Yes, they are retired high court judges.
Yes, retired high court judges are there. But other members are not retired high court judges. Other members are administrative members. But these administrative members also having qualification akin to the equal to the high court judges. Correct? This one. Another thing is, there should be a one common body for the appointment of chairman and member. Aisa nahi ki every ministry or law ministry is appointing these things. Then there will not be a principle of natural justice. So there should be a common body. Okay? Nodal agency. And that nodal agency we can put under law ministry. Instead of ki every department they are appointing their own, we can create one common nodal agency and then we can put under law ministry for the appointment of chairman and members. Correct? And member selection should be very impartial. Member selection should be impartial with minimal interference by government agencies. Correct? Member selection should be impartial with minimal involvement of government agencies. Because government is itself is a party in litigation. Correct? So, iske liye kya kar sakte hain ki The Hindu mein ad le sakte hain first page mein. Okay, jisko jana ho, they can apply there. It is an impartial way. And then why you have selected that particular person, why I have not selected another person, you should disclose on the website. So, minimum interference with the government agency. Tenure should be fixed. Aur wo bhi bada tenure mat karo. Okay, either suppose for chairman ke liye, tenure should be either 3 years or 70 years, whichever is earlier. Aur members ke liye, either 3 years or 67 years aisa tenure kar do and then they should not be appointed again, then they will not be lived by the government because then if suppose there is chance that they are again going to become member or chairman, then government will going to lure them. Correct? And there should be a cooling off period between when we are taking retired judges the part of tribunals, because फिर क्या होगा retired judges होगा, suppose I am the judge, I know that within 1 year I am going to retire, हमारा खाना पीना बंद हो जाएगा, okay, then I will going to be lured by the government कि okay next time I am going to make you the judge in this tribunals, so whatever this judgement आ रहा है, okay, वो judgement मेरे favour में कर दो, definitely I am going to do because I am very corrupt person, everyone is corrupt person. Okay, the form of corruption is different. So definitely, aisa hoga ki nahi hoga, that person will be lured by the government. So there should be some cooling off period. For example, ke 2 years tak he cannot take the judge this. He cannot become the member of the tribunals. Two years cooling off period. In the 2 years, the government will going to change. Then definitely, in the last year of his judiciary, whenever he is here in the high court and judiciary, he will going to actually make judgment in very fair manner. And so this also should be made for to make tribunals independent. Or kya problem tha ki tribunals they are not available geographically everywhere, so we need to create benches, okay, in different parts of the country. करेक्ट दिस, समझ में आ गया? ट्रिब्यूनल पूरा पढ़ लिया हमने एक चैप्टर. नाउ राजस्थान बिल टू सील पब्लिक सर्वेंट.
Sir, when was this tribunal actually came to existence?
Yes, Tribunal Act 1985.
85. Before that, there was no tribunal.
No. Only thing was, before that, 1976, they put 323A article, 323B article. But before, because before 1976, there was no tribunal even. Because tribunal was not available in the constitution.
So the interstate water tribunals.
Yeah, that is different. That comes under Article 264. Okay, that is different. Okay. And these tribunals are permanent in nature. These tribunals are permanent in nature, like income tax appellate tribunal, permanent in nature. Right? Telecom appellate tribunal, permanent in nature. Correct? But this interstate water dispute tribunal, that does not come under this. That is not, that is ad hoc in nature. Or so that already there is inter water dispute act is there. So this interstate water dispute tribunal was came exist under interstate water dispute act 1956. Correct? Now Rajasthan's bill to seal this public servants. Those are the who try the media. So यहाँ पे problem क्या हो गई थी कि there are some this from 156 section is there, section 190 is there, correct? Here section 150 actually is this police power to investigate, or the police power to investigate cognizable offences, correct? And 190 deals with cognizance offence by magistrate. अब इसमें क्या है कि दे कैन नॉट बी कैरीड आउट दिस टू विदाउट प्रायर परमिशन अंडर सेक्शन 197. ओके, दिस पुलिस पावर टू इन्वेस्टिगेट एंड दिस इज सेकंड वन 190 इज कॉग्निजेंस ऑफेंस बाय cognizance of offence by they will be investigated by magistrates. So they cannot be started by magistrate. Now not possible without prior permission. Without prior permission of the government. That not possible. Earlier ये था कि किसी ने पता चला कि that particular public officer he has done any corruption. उसके लिए क्या होता था कि that corruption में you go and file an FIR, then magistrate inquiry will start. But now without prior permission of the government it is not possible. And उसने ये भी बोला, what will be the sanctioning authority? एक authority होगी that sanctioning authority. One sanctioning authority will be there that is going to sanction whether permission will be given or not. Usko time diya gaya ki this authority will be having time 6 months. So till 6 months you cannot actually start any investigation. So it is having 6 months time to decide whether permission need to be given or not. If suppose within 6 months that body is not able to come any conclusion, then you should, without waiting, you can start the investigation. Correct? Yes, I understand. Okay, till 6 months, within 6 months, you need to wait for the permission that is coming, whether to start investigation or not. But if suppose within 6 months, still they are not able to conclusion any, they are not coming, they forgot actually, then you can start your investigation. So 6 months ke liye save kar liya. Aur kya hai?
Why they approve?
Yes.
Rajasthan used to.
Because they were thinking that bureaucrats are not taking decisions because they are under the fear. Because whenever you are taking any decision, then only there is a chances that your decision will become wrong. Correct. When it becomes wrong, then definitely there is punishment is 100%. Okay. If it becomes good, then there is no reward is available. Correct? So if you are not taking decision, then there is no chance of wrong. In government, to do work there is punishment, not to do work there is no punishment. So not to do work, salary to save me, hai na? So there will come policy paralysis. They are not taking decisions. So that is why we need to provide them. Well, there are some honest individuals are there. They are having this fear. So to save them, actually government, Rajasthan government has initiated this thing. Correct? And one more thing, media also actually was asked not to share any information of the accused until unless investigation starts. Mean till 6 months, media also cannot share information regarding that particular officer. Correct? So this will also prevent media from sharing the information. Ab ye kya hua? Aghat hua kis pe? Freedom of press. Okay? Because freedom of press mein kya hai? There is no reasonable restrictions. Whatever the reasonable restrictions are there, war 1920 mein is not available. But if we have put some extra, so it can become unconstitutional also. Correct or not? So this is the thing that it also prevents media from sharing the information about the accusation, allegations around that person also. So which is a grave threat to the freedom of media.
They can go to sanctioning authority, right?
Yes.
They can go to sanctioning authority.
Yes. You cannot start until unless sanctioning authority is saying that you can start investigation.
No. Media can directly go to sanctioning.
No. Media cannot.
So who are the sanctioning authorities?
Sanctioning authority is actually the based on their creating which officer is involved. Okay, suppose officer is based on under joint secretary, under secretary, then definitely it will come from cabinet only. So in the basis of sanctioning authority is different. So we do not require to know who is sanctioning authority. Correct? So why government ka kya view hai? Why government has put this? The government view is this to prevent actually, to protect the honest officials. This is the government view from frivolous allegations. Okay? Because jab wo politician ki baat nahi maan rahe hain, some chote mote nahi hote hain politicians, if you are not accepting, then they are going to file some FIR against you. So that the thing is to protect the honest officials from frivolous allegations labeled by some vested interest. Correct? So that is why it prevents policy paralysis. That what happens during UPA era time. Then UPA second time, the UPA second, this was the issue actually happening with. Because a lot of scams came during this time. 2G, 3G, Jija G, 4G, Party G. Lot of scams came. So in that scam, what happened? That all bureaucrats, they stopped working. Because they feared that next time, only ke naam pe one scam will come. When they stopped working, they stopped signing any file. इससे क्या होगा कि कंप्लीट पॉलिसी पैरालिसिस केम इन यूपीए सेकंड गवर्नमेंट सो टू एक्चुअली अवॉइड दैट सिचुएशन हियर एक्चुअली गवर्नमेंट हैज पुट दिस प्रायर सैंक्शनिंग करेक्ट This government ka view aa gaya. Now what is Supreme Court's view? Government view is to protect the honest officials and to avoid the policy paralysis. Now Supreme Court ka view hai ki dono side mein, like Gandhi ji. Correct? Ki in one case is okay, definitely it is always good to prevent those honest officials. Another case, this is violation of right to equality, article number 14. So Supreme Court is having both views. Same thing, there is one prevention of corruption act is there. Prevention of Corruption Act. There is one section 19 is there. In this section 19 of Prevention of Corruption Act also requires prior permission for prosecution. So this also requires. So aisa nahi ki this is new actually. This is already available. Also requires prior permission for prosecution. Correct. Same in Maharashtra also. When there was a Congress government that time also, there was this law is there. Same as it is Rajasthan. Same. Aisa nahi kuch different hai. Same. Only difference is that ki Rajasthan case mein time limit is 6 months. In Maharashtra case time limit is 3 month. Only this difference is there. Correct? But yahan pe hue cry ho gaya because we know that BJP government hai, so that is the always good thing about BJP. They cannot do anything wrong because media will going to bite them. Okay. That is why I always want BJP everywhere. Okay, because until unless BJP is not there, only government is there, they can do any wrong, but media is not going to bite them. Correct? So, same thing is there in Maharashtra also, but their sanctioning time is 3 years. 3 months, sorry. But in case of 6 months. So, SRA, this is the new. You can defend also. This is already available in our central part, means government law prevention of corruption act is already there. Maharashtra, it is available. But way forward में आपको कैसा लिखना है? आपको always these things avoid करना है. Correct? Way forward में you can instead of अपना खुद के ऊपर मत लो. Okay? Don't take on your own blame. You are going to remove this. पता चला वो BJP का हो गया तो दिक्कत आ जाएगी. So आप simply कर दो कि there is Supreme Court already. There was Delhi Special Police Establishment in CBI case was going on. In CBI case also the same thing is available कि prior permission is required in CBI case and there was famous section was section 6A. Okay, in Delhi Special Police Establishment Act, in Delhi Special Police Establishment Act, it is nothing but CBI. Okay, so here maybe one section 6A is there. Before CBI inquiry, you require prior permission of the government. So Supreme Court says that section 6A is violating article number 14, what is the spirit of article 14, correct? Now you can conclude this thing, way forward you can write ki while invalidating this section 6A of Delhi Special Police Establishment Act, Supreme Court already clarified that it is violating the spirit of 14 and that actually judgment should become the touchstone to know the constitutionality of this act. Finish, aapne apne upar liya hi nahi kuch bhi. आप जाओ सुप्रीम कोर्ट में बोलो जाके, ठीक है ना? सो इन सच वे यू नीड टू राइट आंसर, वेरी डिप्लोमेटिक. ओके, एंड फर्दर देयर इज अ नीड टू ऑपरेशनलाइज द लोकपाल एक्ट जो अभी तक नहीं आया है. ठीक है, देयर इज एक्ट इज देयर बट देयर इज नो लोकपाल इज अवेलेबल. करेक्ट, सो देयर इज अ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ ऑपरेशनलाइजेशन ऑफ लोकपाल एक्ट सो दैट देयर दोज पर्संस आल्सो कैन डू सम करप्शन. So, समझ में आ गया ये? आपको यही बोलना है कि whether this is new already or there already such type of act is already present. Yes, such type of act is already present. वो आपके prevention of corruption act में, अगर आपको section याद ना हो, still you can forget that. That is not required. You need to remember section by section. But आपको remember रखना है prevention of corruption act जरूर. दिल्ली स्पेशल पुलिस आपको इतना नहीं पढ़ा याद में, दैट इज देयर वाज वन सीबीआई केस इज देयर इन सच वे रेफरेंस में यू कैन पुट ओवर देयर इन सच वे यू कैन रिमेंबर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज ई समीक्षा. So what is this e-samiksha? Padha hoga. Nahi padha ye samiksha abhi tak. Notes mein nahi tha. Tha hoga zarur 100%. What is e-samiksha? सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट है जो स्पेसिफिक टारगेट, ये प्रीलिम्स के लिए इम्पोर्टेंट भी है और मेंस के लिए भी इम्पोर्टेंट है. तो ये समीक्षा है जिसमें सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट हैव बीन आस्क्ड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी टू वर्क एक्चुअली सम स्पेसिफिक टारगेट्स यू नीड टू कंप्लीट बाय ओके बाय 2022. क्या स्पेसिफिक है इस ईयर को? सारा कुछ आप 75 years new India will come. Okay, the new passport will come. So this the thing is the central government was asked all department to be asked to actually complete some specific target to be achieved by 2020. So Modi's specific target is like house for all by 2022. Correct. 175 gigawatt renewable energy by 2020. ग्राम विद्युत निगरण होना है सबको मिलना चाहिए लाइट बाय 2020 सारा कुछ 2020 हो जाना चाहिए ठीक है ना बट अगर यू आर नॉट एबल टू मेजर दोज थिंग्स कि वेदर रिपोर्टिंग अ प्राइम मिनिस्टर ही इज वर्किंग इतना उनके पास टाइम नहीं कि टू गो एंड आस्क एवरीज व्हाट्सएप करेंगे आपका कितना काम हो गया सो फॉर दैट देयर शुड बी सम ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म वो ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म जस्ट लाइक ए डैशबोर्ड जहां पे ही कैन एक्चुअली जस्ट सिट ऑन द टेबल एंड check which ministry is working what kya kya kaam complete hua hai nahi so that is actually e-samiksha so it is actually a online platform monitoring and compliance mechanism so it is online correct monitoring and compliance mechanism and compliance mechanism ये है चीज डेवलप्ड बाय कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरीएट डेवलप्ड बाय कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरीएट ऐसा नहीं कि दो आईएएस ऑफिसर और सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर खाली बैठे थे बना दिए सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ नेशनल इंफॉर्मेटिक सेंटर एनआईसी राइट सो दिस डेवलप्ड बाय कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरीएट So who is going to monitor? आपको क्या ध्यान रखना है? Who is going to monitor actually में? So that will be monitored by two person. एक तो आपका cabinet secretary, correct? Another is prime minister. And that is also on real time basis. Correct? रियल टाइम बेसिस करेक्ट अब सपोज व्हेन ही देयर विल बी वन कंप्लीट जैसे उनके टेबल में एक डैशबोर्ड बन जाएगा ऑनलाइन वाला ना यहां पे डिफरेंट मिनिस्ट्री के फ्लेक्सिक प्रोग्राम्स होंगे ही जस्ट कैन टच एंड देन व्हाटएवर द प्रोग्रेस इज गोइंग ऑन सब कुछ चेक कर लें एंड सपोज ही फाउंड दैट कि देन वन पर्टिकुलर डिपार्टमेंट इज नॉट वर्किंग वेल और ही इज दैट डिपार्टमेंट इज लैगिंग देन ही कैन सेंड सम मैसेजेस आल्सो फॉर दैट एक्चुअली देयर इज ई पत्राचार इज आल्सो पत्राचार इज टू सेंड SMS ईमेल मींस नॉट वेट कि आप चिट्ठी लिख रहे हो देन इंडिया पोस्ट वाला देने जा रहा है देन अगेन रिप्लाई आ रहा है सब कुछ सर मंगल है आशा करता हूँ वहां पे भी सब ठीक होगा सो ऐसा चीज नहीं है इट इज जस्ट ईमेल सो रियल टाइम बेसिस करेक्ट सो ई पत्राचार इज ऑल्सो ओवर देयर सो इट एक्चुअली ए गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मिनिमम गवर्नमेंट मैक्सिमम गवर्नेंस एक चीज आपके पास ई गवर्नेंस है टॉपिक इन जीएस पेपर टू यू कैन यूटिलाइज दैट आल्सो इन ई गवर्नेंस करेक्ट एंड टू मेक गुड गवर्नेंस के एग्जांपल यू कैन यूज दिस दिस इज द गुड गवर्नेंस बिकॉज रियल टाइम बेसिस द प्रोजेक्ट इज चेक्ड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरी दैट इज गुड गवर्नेंस कि वेदर दैट एबल टू कंप्लीट देयर वर्क और नॉट सो यू कैन यूटिलाइज इन गुड गवर्नेंस वाला क्वेश्चन में पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वाले दे कैन यूज दिस ई गवर्नेंस दे कैन यूज दिस मिनिमम गवर्नमेंट मैक्सिमम गवर्नेंस का इससे फायदा क्या होगा आपकी इफिशियंसी विल इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज सो इनहेंस इफिशियंसी राइट ट्रांसपेरेंसी विल इंप्रूव ब्रिंग ट्रांसपेरेंसी करेक्ट Accountability increase or decrease? Increase accountability. Communication increase or decrease? Okay. Improve communication. These things actually will be the outcome of this e-samiksha. Whenever क्या होगा उनके ऑनलाइन सिस्टम में there is any file is stuck in between, okay and that particular officer is not able to pass that file and PM and cabinet secretary can check that and then he actually going to press one button and automatically in this particular officer's screen PC screen पे red signal will start coming, okay then he will understood okay उन्होंने देख लिया पढ़ लिया है ठीक है ना पास कर लिया सर व्हाट्सएप पे हम लोग करते हैं रीड कर लिया फिर भी रिप्लाई नहीं किया ठीक है ना सो दिस टाइप ऑफ हाइड बटन देयर इज नो अवेलेबल ठीक है सो इन सच वे पीएम एंड कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरी कैन डू दिस थिंग इवन नाउ स्टेट लेवल में भी दिस ये समीक्षा टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स दे स्टार्टेड लाइक रिसेंटली उत्तर प्रदेश ओके आदित्य योगी नाथ गवर्नमेंट ही हैज आल्सो स्टार्टेड द सेम टाइप ऑफ दिस ई समीक्षा इन उत्तर प्रदेश same online dashboard has been created and that has started working also correct so this is important for your mains exam good e-governance good governance and prelims exam mein also important what is e-samiksha is there so wo old pattern baat likh ke denge ek acha baat hoga easily you can create e-samiksha kuch bhi nahi hai samadhi hai is type ki jo electronically di jayegi okay so really this type of prelims question easily you can take क्या जो फोर ऑप्शंस होते हैं ना इफ यू रीड ओनली वन टाइम स्टिल यू कैन आंसर सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन जो थ्री ऑप्शंस होंगे इतने ऊटपटांग होंगे कि कोई एरिया नहीं होगा उनका नेक्स्ट इज एक और ई गवर्नेंस में वन थिंग ब्रॉट आउट दिस पब्लिक फाइनेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम
UP is a state
in not UP most of BJP government start they are following Modi actually on Twitter also sir most governments so you should not remember which is the first state is doing that will be asked only in state exam but only that state exam mein hoga jis state ne pehle follow kiya that's it okay suppose Karnataka is not followed to Karnataka state exam mein this question will not come apni marzi thodi na todwayega so agar UP mein they are asking question definitely UP so in which state they are asking that state is the first right so this is the guess or how you can utilize your guess or without knowing the answer psychology clear behavioral so public finance management system this is one of the example of e-governance how to increase because we require only these are the core value of administration government aapko inhi cheez pe dhyan efficiency transparency accountability communication public interest these things you need to take care of that is all about ethics paper so in ethics paper mein also you can utilize these things now public finance management system what is this public finance management system it is also a web based software application correct and it is developed and implemented by CGA CGA क्या है कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ अकाउंट्स CAG डिफरेंट है CGA डिफरेंट है करेक्ट इट इज कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ अकाउंट सो कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ अकाउंट्स का मेन वर्क क्या है टू प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ओके व्हाट हाउ मच मनी कहां पे गया वेयर दे हैव स्पेंड दैट थिंग्स सो प्रॉब्लम क्या हो रहा है अभी कि वी डू नॉट नो हाउ मच फंड्स हैज बीन स्पेंड ओवर देयर ऑन रियल टाइम बेसिस मतलब अगर सपोज प्राइम मिनिस्टर टुडे वांट्स हाउ मच फंड दैट पर्टिकुलर स्कीम में खर्च हुआ है हाउ मच मनी इज अनस्पेंड अब यू आर एबल टू कम टू नो ओनली आफ्टर वन ईयर दैट बिकम्स अ पोस्ट मॉर्टम टाइप ऑफ इशू नाउ यू कैन नॉट गो बैक सो दिस इज द रियल टाइम बेसिस बेटर मॉनिटरिंग ऑफ फंड्स एंड ट्रांसपेरेंसी यहां से इट विल कम आउट टू अबाउट दिस सेंट्रली गवर्नमेंट सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम एंड सेंट्रली सेक्टर स्कीम्स ऑफ व्हाटएवर द अमाउंट्स हैज बीन गिवन वेदर दैट फंड्स हैव बीन यूटिलाइज्ड और नॉट दैट विल बी कम टू नोन टू द गवर्नमेंट डायरेक्टली ऑन रियल टाइम बेसिस सो इसका इंपॉर्टेंट बेनिफिट क्या होगा इट विल गोइंग टू इंप्रूव बेटर मॉनिटरिंग ओके ऑफ फंड्स एंड ट्रांसपेरेंसी correct? A better financial management will also improve. Better financial management for the sense ki in real time basis, whenever just in time release of fund will happen. Abhi problem kya hai ki we are not able to release funds on time also. We have given one scheme, then it will taking 1 year, then funds is coming. Uske baad janta ka bhi mood khatam ho gaya. Okay, sab problem ho gaya. And ye ho jata hai ki cost overrun happens. Because inflation is there. Today वो चीज़ हो सकती थी 10 rupees में, tomorrow it requires 20 rupees and you are releasing fund tomorrow. So tomorrow you need to pay two times cost overrun will happen. So यहाँ पे क्या होगा? Better financial management will happen. So इससे आपकी fiscal deficit will be controlled. Because extra money you need not to spend now. Okay, money you are going to spend only on real time basis only. The fiscal deficit will reduce. Example will think कितना सोचते हो? ना तो government ने भी नहीं सोचा था. Okay, this is really going to reduce fiscal deficit, but you can put. Correct? Or kya issue hoga? Adoption of e-governance and good governance. Okay? Because completely transparency is there. And it also addresses the issue of rat tapism. Because if someone is not able to issue that funds, Prime Minister and Cabinet Secretary easily can see in public finance management application ki which actually officer has not released the fund on time. So it is going to address the rat tapism also. So policy paralysis will going on then. Okay, policy paralysis things will not come. Correct. So it is also going to address the stalling of funds and rat tapism.
So kya fund?
Stalling of funds. Jo unnecessary parks run by implementing agencies, they are just parked in their own accounts, but they are not giving the monies to those who are working. Like example, Manrega mein money chala bhi gaya hai. That is why government, it is also good thing to work with direct beneficiary DBT scheme, direct benefit transfer, same as it is.
Save some money.
Yes. So already there are 13 central sector schemes are there. They have actually implemented this public finance management system. And PRM has enabled the government in taking forward this DBT initiative, Direct Benefit Transfer Scheme initiative, to centrally center scheme and centrally disorder scheme also. Itna hi aapko gyan rakhna hai, that's it. But only aapko gyan kya rakhna hai as an example. If question is coming regarding good governance, regarding financial propriety, all this, you can put as an example. Correct? Straightforward question ke chances bahut kam hai. Next comes anti-torture legislation. So there is before anti-torture, there is United Nations Convention is there, United Nations Convention against torture. United Nations Convention against torture. Can't. Convention against torture. So it is a human rights instrument aimed to prevent this torture and cruelty in human. This degrading treatment, punishment around the world. So for that this United Nations Convention against Torture came. So ab aapko kya dhyan rakhne ka, whether India has ratified this convention or not. So India has ratified already this 1997. But the thing is this, sorry, India had signed this convention. Okay. Signed this convention in 1997. But signed is not enough. Aapko kya karna chahiye? In your own parliament, you need to pass this. Correct? So India has not ratified yet. India has not ratified yet. Ab ratified nahi kiya, then it is not valid in your country. Even India has tried in 2010. This. ये पास भी हो गया था वेयर इन लोकसभा Then 2013 में आपका it was just about to come in as a इनके पास टाइम नहीं था. देन 2014 क्या हुआ? रिजोल्यूशन आपको पता है, इफ इट इज पास फ्रॉम लोकसभा बट स्टिल इट नॉट कम इन राज्यसभा देन दैट बिल गोइंग टू कोलैप्स्ड. करेक्ट, सो लैप्स्ड हो गया ये बिल. सो दैट इज द रीजन इट इज. अब गवर्नमेंट को क्या चाहिए? गवर्नमेंट रिक्वायर्ड टू अगेन इंट्रोड्यूस रिजोल्यूशन अगेन फ्रॉम लोकसभा एज वेल एज राज्यसभा. नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाई मैक्सिमम एक्चुअली लेट्स दे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम राज्यसभा जस्ट टू अवॉइड दिस सिचुएशन. अगर सोचो ये पहले ही राज्यसभा में जाता एंड देन राज्यसभा इज जस्ट पासिंग देन इवन न्यू लोकसभा विल कम ओनली यू नीड टू पास थ्रू लोकसभा दैट्स इट. करेक्ट, सो दैट इज द गुड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. मोस्ट ऑफ लेजिस्लेटर्स दे आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन राज्यसभा फर्स्ट अवॉइड सच थिंग्स. करेक्ट, स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग दिस फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ ईयर. सो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज नॉट रेटिफाइड दिस यूनाइटेड नेशन कन्वेंशन अगेंस्ट टॉर्चर. Even though National Human Rights Commission already supported this, National Human Rights Commission already supported this, and that bill name was Prevention of Torture Bill. Prevention of Torture Bill 2010. Why? What is the reason Government of India has not signed? Not ratified, because they are saying that there is a lack of state government consent. Because police power kiski hai? State ki. So they are interfering in the state matters and they are saying that state government is not ready for that. That is why we are not able to ratify this. One reason. Second reason, they are saying that already we are having lot of sections in IPC and CRPC. Already we are having so many sections over there to prevent torture. When we are already sufficient measures are available in our criminal jurisdiction system, then there is no requirement of another further law. So these were the reasons cited by the government not to ratify. Correct.
To comply with the international treaties.
Yes.
The role of the state will be minimum.
Minimum care nothing. Okay, article number 253. Correct. But still कोई बहाना तो चाहिए. This is democracy. Okay, कि बहाना मांग रहे हैं. लेकिन there is one actually this PIL while filed by Ashwini Kumar Chaube, that is Congress minister. Earlier he was law minister. खुद तो पास नहीं कर पाए. ठीक है. और अब PIL file कर रहे हैं against NDA government. BJP government. Why you are not passing? जब आप थे तो आप ही कर लेते. ठीक है ना. तो he has filed this application in that means FIR. Sorry PIL. He said this. Already 90% of the state is okay with this. Okay, then why you are not introducing this law? So he has actually filed PIL on individual basis. Correct. So already he is saying that 90% of states are okay with this, but you are not doing this. But state government kya hota hai ki okay in one form, not okay in another form, because no one is going to lose power. Basically, it is the state government that mostly misuse investigative machinery, police machinery. It is not a central government. Okay, it is a state government. That is why they are not going to lose power here. So, why actually there is requirement of anti-torture legislation? Kya reason hai? First thing is, reason kya hai? Ki, whenever any extradition happens, okay, ki one criminal that is actually in other state, other country, if we need to bring that particular criminal in our country, kya hai ki we need, and that country already signed this United Nations Convention against torture. So aapko kya whenever you need to convince that country, we are not going to torture that person, we are not going to give death penalty to that person. Tabhi wo yahan pe aayega. Abu Salim case, you know, this was actually promise has been given by government of India ki we are not going to give death penalty, then only that particular country has sent Abu Salim. Correct, otherwise not going to send. So you are not party of United Nations Convention against torture, then there is always an issue of extradition. Vijay Malia case is same. Tihar jail mein maza nahi aayega. Ki kaun sa maza chahiye? Aur jail mein agar maza hi chahiye to jail ja ke rahe ho. Jail maza ke liye thodi na hai. Theek hai na? So that the thing is this, ki we are not party of this, that is why state means countries are not ready for extradition. Right, this is one issue is here.
Which is a monitoring agency?
Yes.
monitoring agency for this?
Monitoring agencies for?
For this.
After you are signed, kar liya, uske baad you are not hearing anything, there is no, nothing to worry. Okay? Same jail, same torture will be available. Only thing is you need to sign and ratify, that's it. Correct? So, इससे फायदा क्या होगा? One फायदा जो है हमारा difficulty in extradition है, that will be removed. Okay? Difficulty to secure extraditions will going to be smooth. For example, there was one person was Kim Devi. एक केस था पुरुलिया arms case, West Bengal में ना. The Kim Devi person was that was not Denmark had denied extraditions of Kim Devi because Denmark said that you are not the party of retaliation against against torture and that is why you are going to treat this actually being human in very torture way in human way because usne inhuman work kiya that does not mean you are also going to do inhuman work correct so that way that person was not extradited so ye humko fayda ho jayega ki extradition mein whatever the problems are coming we need to convince abhi right now we need to convince on personal level then we do not require correct ye fayda hai another is it is also important in the context of human rights violations for example human rights violations in the area of jahan pe ye hai okay armed force special power act northeastern states lot of human rights violations are happening torture is happening so it is also helpful in these areas correct एक तो ये दूसरा फायदा ये हुआ कि दोज ह्यूमन राइट वायलेशन हैपनिंग इन दीज एरियाज नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट जम्मू कश्मीर एरियाज दैट विल बी अवॉइडेड देन थर्ड आपको बेनिफिट कहां पे होगा कि व्हेनेवर एनी कस्टडियल डेथ हैपेंस एनएचआरसी हैज सेड द एनएचआरसी कि व्हेनेवर कस्टडियल डेथ हैपेंड देन देयर इज अ मैंडेटरी रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ दैट कस्टडियल डेथ यू नीड टू रिपोर्ट कस्टडियल डेथ इन द सेंस व्हेन डेथ हैपेंस इन द मींस इन द कस्टडी ऑफ पुलिस बट अबाउट कस्टडियल वायलेंस That is not mandatory to report, correct? So custodial death में even torture वाले वो person तो चला गया कोई torture नहीं है ना, लेकिन custodial violence में person is still there, so that is more dangerous compared to death, correct? So that is another problem. In NHRC says that there is a mandatory reporting of custodial death, but not custodial violence, and that is why we require this United Nations Convention against torture. Correct this. Another benefit क्या होगा? It is also going to improve the image of India as a vibrant democracy. In the context of Article number 21, fundamental right to life. यही तो है. Correct. So it is again improve the image of India in the world as a vibrant democratic country. In the context of Article 21. That is why government is preparing now for this prevention of torture bill 2017 already government has drafted prevention of torture bill 2017 but the problem wahi hai wide definition of torture
does, okay does prevention of detention comes under this
no that is different okay
so article 20 We have self-incrimination.
Yes.
Violence or for self-incrimination.
Yes, we cannot do definitely. That is violation of Article 20. Correct. But again, Article 20 तभी valid होगा जब उसके पास एक legislation भी होगा ना. Fundamental rights are not applicable on its own. We require some supportive legislation also. Like Article 17, untouchability. Libya, untouchability. But still, someone is promoting untouchability. You cannot prevent that. So that is why government has carried out Consumer Rights Act, Civil Rights Act 1955. Correct. So that's we require actually here also. And some law commission also suggested that there should be presumptions of guilt. Presumptions of guilt in the sense. कि बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ विल बी शुड बी ऑन द पुलिस. एक तो प्रिजम्पशन ऑफ इनोसेंट, जब तक वो प्रूफ नहीं होगा दैट पर्सन रिमेन इनोसेंट. बट यहाँ पे लॉ कमीशन इज सेइंग दैट देयर शुड बी प्रिजम्पशन ऑफ गिल्ट अंटिल अनलेस पुलिस इज गिविंग कन्विंसिंग प्रूफ कि दे हैव नॉट डन दिस, दे विल रिमेन गिल्टी. करेक्ट. सो दिस थिंग की रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ लॉ कमीशन, एंड वी नो दैट मिलिट्री इन लॉ वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू यूज ऑल दीज थिंग्स, बट लॉ कमीशन हैज पुट दिस रिकमेंडेशन देयर शुड बी अ प्रिजम्पशन ऑफ गिल्ट. करेक्ट. And second law commission is saying that there should be a compensation and rehabilitation also. आज इसका torture हुआ है ना, correct? Compensation should be given to that person. Rehabilitation should be given to that person. For example, we have seen कि whenever any terrorist activism happens act, and then police used to actually capture some Muslim persons, and then after 7 or 10 years we have come to know कि they were actually innocent. अब आपने 10 years की life, अब whatever you are going to return. You are, because there is no provision of any compensation, so you have done all torture. So in that case, we need to provide compensation as well as rehabilitation to that person. Okay? Or kya hona chahiye? Ki whenever torture ho raha hai, those person who are doing torture, they are not going to report we are doing torture. Come here. Correct. For that, someone will be witness. Okay. Those who are whistleblowers will be there. So those protections of victims, protections of complaint. And protections of witnesses need to be given. Correct? Samajh mein aa gaya? So these were the total policies that came in this October month. आप कौन सा सेक्शन पढ़ना है, इकोनॉमी और इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन? यस आईआर, क्योंकि पढ़ा नहीं कभी. कौन सा पार्ट, इकोनॉमी और आईआर?
आईआर
इतने अच्छे आईआर है. ठीक है, इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन कितने मिनट का? 2 मिनट क्या
कर दो मिनट आते आते 10 मिनट हो
जाएंगे. आपकी बात
That's